Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Minutemen Dynasty here in NCAA 13. Yep, look at this. Robert Vincent only 2 weeks away from returning. Remember Robert Vincent and his breakout game to start the year? And then he went on the injury list for a long, long time. Dustin Jones has done a great job filling in, and he's made a name for himself. But man, when we can get Robert Vincent back in that lineup just in time for some key ball games at the end of our run here, looking to see if we can actually take this national championship. Yes, we are number one in the nation. It's been a long 5-year project here. Well, it really hasn't been that long when you think about it, coming in here and in 5 years taking this team to the top of college football. But hey, we'll take it. Wake Forest is on the schedule today. We traveled to Wake Forest to take on the Demon Deacons. And here we go, 3rd and 5 for Wake Forest. Cameron's thrown over the middle. That's a really nice catch by Schultz. My goodness, he plucked that one. Looked like one-handed out of midair. 3rd and 1 now. Handoff out of the pistol end. That is not going to get them a first down. Nice stop by the UMass defense. And here we go with Joel Meadows and company on offense for the first time. And that's Dustin Jones around the left-hand side. He will get 9 yards plus. It'll be 2nd and inches. They fake to him. And oh, they bit on that play fake. Look how open Ronnie Houston is. He makes the catch and he's gone, folks. That is a long touchdown pass on the play action. Watch right here as they make this defensive back bite and bite hard on that play action. And there goes Ronnie Houston right by him. Nobody within a zip code of him as he makes this catch and goes into the end zone. 7-0 UMass, just like that. Yep, that's exactly what you hope for when you run play action, and it works to perfection right there. So here we go back to Wake Forest on offense, and they are hitting Harrell, who's going to turn up the sideline and get past midfield. Nice play right there. They face a 3rd and 11 and trying to get him off the field once again. But it's Harrell again, and he makes another nice catch inside the 30 down to the 26. And Wake Forest is moving the ball. 2nd and 13. Cameron will find Owens, who makes a catch and pops out of bounds. It'll be 3rd and inches. Big play right here. They bring the blitz, but Cameron finds it and beats it with the pass to Jones. He walks in the end zone. Yep, the blitz almost gets to him, but not quick enough. Wake Forest ties the score. They answer on a nice offensive drive right here to make this a 7-7 ball game with about 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Let's see the replay again. Just a nice little crossing pattern here, and it's a good timing because his quarterback can get rid of the ball just in time. He took a big hit, but he'll trade off that for a touchdown. So 7-7, handing off to Dustin Jones in the pistol. He'll get about 4 yards, 2nd and 6. Hand off on the counterplay to the left. It's Dustin Jones again. He's fighting for extra yards. It'll be 3rd and 1 at the result of that play. And we hand off to Jones again. Yep, he's got a first down. Nice job right there by the offense. But they find themselves 2nd and 14 here after an end around to Ronnie Houston that didn't work. Nice little pass there. We'll make it 3rd and 4. They need a short pass, but no, it's jumped by Wake Forest defense right there. Sanders makes the pick, and they're going the other way in UMass territory. Oh, Meadows didn't see that. He locked onto his receiver quickly, wanted to just get that quick reception for a first down, and instead, Wake Forest comes up with an opportunistic turnover and a chance to take the lead on number one UMass. Let's see what they do right here. 1st and 10, Cameron wants to throw, and he's finding Schultz. Nice catch, 1st and 10, and Tyler Cameron already has 105 yards. 3rd and 3, they got to come up with a big play here. They hand off to Johnson. He will dance around and get in the end zone. UMass has no answer for this offense on the last two drives, and it's a 14-7 Wake Forest lead. Oh, can we have an upset here? Well, it's still really early, so we won't get all preoccupied with those thoughts just yet, but UMass is going to have to tighten things up on defense here really quickly, or they're going to have a headache all day long. So they've got to neutralize their turnovers, first of all, on offense. That's a handoff to Jones that goes for 4 yards. 2nd and 6. They try that play action that works so well. Nah, they bring a blitz this time, and they say, nope, not going to get it this time. Nice job blitzing from the blind side here, and the play action play will not work for UMass this time. So now they got a 3rd and 11 and got to come up with something out of the shotgun. They go a quick pass to Luke Dunn. Luke Dunn is going to stretch the field on this, however. They're not going to catch him. He is gone. Luke Dunn with the 80-yard touchdown reception just like that. UMass has tied the score They are a quick scoring machine today. They prefer to be scoring on the long touchdown plays here instead of sustained drives that we normally see. That's a big play. Luke Dunn makes a short catch into a long gain with the run after catch. And it is 14-all when he scores on the 80-yard touchdown pass. Okay, 14-all. Hand off to Johnson, who had run well in the last series, getting into the end zone. Another nice run there. They have 3rd and 5, and Cameron looking for a pass, but that's not a good one. Dennis steps in front of it, and he is gone. Pick 6 for the Minutemen, and they are in the lead, 21-14. A very good defensive play right here. Read the route. Jumped right in front of the big receiver and takes off down the sideline untouched for the interception and touchdown. Great job by UMass's defense responding here. I said they'd have to change some things. Well, at least for this drive, they figured some things out and they get a big defensive score to turn the tide here. They are now in the lead 21-14 with a minute 30 before halftime. Can the defense come up with a big stop again here and keep that the score before half? Cameron scrambling a little bit, finds Schultz. Nice catch, and they get near midfield. So with about a minute left, Cameron has some pressure in his face, but he finds Owens for a first down. They're moving the ball again. 35 seconds and counting. Cameron's got another chance. He's going to load up for the sideline. Nope, that's thrown high and out of bounds. It'll be 4th and 4, and they try a long field goal attempt. About 50 yards. It will be off the upright, no good. So that will be your halftime score, UMass 21, Wake Forest 14, as both teams head for a breather. It's been a wild first half, and if the second half is anything like this, we're in for a great game. 2nd and 9 for Meadows, deep in their own territory. He finds his tight end. Nice job getting a first down right there. Meadows to Stokes again for 9 yards, and Joel Meadows now has 200 yards passing, thanks to 2 long touchdown strikes. Here's Stokes again, and he makes the catch. First down. Nice job bailing him out of a long yardage situation right there. 1st down and 10. Hand off to Dustin Jones, and it'll be about a 4-yard gain. 2nd and 6. Jones again. Look, and he's got the blocking out front there. He's going to get down to about the 12-yard line. Nice, successful run for UMass there. Great blocking out front. Jones cutting through the gaps right there and getting another 7-yard rush or so. He's got 65 on the day on 10 carries. 3rd and 2. And we have Joseph Jones checking into the game, but he will not be able to get the first down. He's the power back, and they have to settle for the Patton field goal. So it is a 10-point lead, 24-14. 3rd quarter now, 2:16 remaining. Cameron handing off to Johnson, who again has success running out of that shotgun formation. Why not try it again? 1st and 10. What a spin move right there. He gets himself to midfield. Juked a Minuteman defender out of his shorts right there. Nice play. They are running the ball successfully in this drive, but Cameron wants to throw now. And he finds Schultz bouncing off a defender who's trying to tackle him on his way to 1st and goal. Hand off to Johnson again, and he is in the end zone. This Wake Forest offense is clicking here when they avoid the turnovers. This is a team that's been hard to stop for this UMass defense, and they seemingly can score at will if they don't make the mistakes against themselves there with the turnovers. So 1st and 10, handing off to Dustin Jones. We got to stay ahead of things here with the 3-point lead. We don't want to have a 3 and out. Meadows on 2nd and 4 is going to find Dustin Jones out of the backfield for some relief, and they get a 1st down on that short pass. Hand off to him here, and he's going to get a good 7 yards. 2nd and 3. Hand off again as we're in the 4th quarter. The game stutters and then comes to a complete halt. But when it finally comes back, Dustin Jones is following the blocking out front very nicely to a 1st down run. We hand off again on a bit of a counter or trap play. He'll get 4 yards. 3rd and 6 now. Meadows is motioning his man out of the backfield, which is Joseph Jones. That's complete, but no. It is out of bounds, and it'll be 4th down. A really long field goal attempt. Patton from 53 yards. He got it. He got the 53-yarder. Patton continues to be clutch. We got the 6-point lead now, but you give Wake Forest a chance to come back and score, except look out. Brian Pino jumps in front of this, leaps, makes the catch. It is another pick six, the 2nd of the day from this UMass defense. This time it's the young linebacker coming up with the big play. Yeah, he leaps in the air to get this one, and no one in his way from scoring the defensive touchdown on the interception. UMass's D coming up big in the turnover category here today, making them count with two pick sixes. The score now 34-21. But when they want to, you know this Wake Forest offense is pretty potent. Now, how do we let them gink that catch? You got to knock that ball down. That is not a good deal there for UMass's defense. Third and 11, they'll stop them just short. Fourth and one, but you know they're going for it. Cameron goes for everything, and they get the end zone touchdown. Just kind of a floater of a pass, but it works out for Cameron, finding his man, and they'll give him the end zone here on this play. Let's see. Very close, but yeah, I think he crossed the plane of the goal line before Young hits him, and that is a touchdown Wake Forest. It's not over yet. They opt to not go for the onside kick. They kick deep, so now it's time to try to kill this clock. There is a nice run by Dustin Jones. Second and two. Get that first down, Dustin, and he does. And he hangs onto the ball. He's out to the 45-yard line. Second and 10 now. Jones running hard. That'll be the last Wake Forest timeout. Let's get one more first down. Off to the left. Looking for enough room, and he just does get it. First and 10. That should just about do it here. Got to hang onto this ball. 1:33 left. Dustin Jones, a nice little run inside the 30. Wanted to stay in bounds so badly there, but couldn't. But this game is over. The kneel down, and UMass wins it. Let's not say convincingly. It was a close game, but they stay undefeated with the 34-28 victory over Wake Forest. Road games are always hard when you are a highly ranked team there and teams want to bring their best and try to knock you off a peg. Well, it doesn't happen today. They win and remain in that number one spot in the nation. So, time to celebrate. Wendell Patton gets your player of the game. Nice. He got that 53-yard field goal. That helps. And he was 4-for-4 from extra points. Had another short field goal. I guess he was the difference there in the score. So, Joel Meadows has two interceptions. One of them was meaningless right before halftime. I didn't even show that in the package. It was kind of like a Hail Mary attempt. So, Dustin Jones, 20 attempts for 147 yards. How does he feel about the eventual return of Robert Vincent? Oh boy, we might have a crowded backfield here, and who deserves to start? We just know that Robert Vincent was so explosive with that speed and with that acceleration with what we saw in the first ball game or two before he was knocked out. So you see the stats here, getting into the defensive stats, and Thomas Young again leading the way with 13 tackles, 7 of those solo, Ben Birch right in there as well, Dennis with a pick, Pino with a pick, they both score. And that's a big game there as UMass finds a way to get it done, 34-28. So we go into our recruiting for the week. Just a brief snapshot of what we're doing here as it's been a very successful recruiting year yet again. Looks like we may lose someone here to BYU. That's Nugent, the 79 overall guard. We'll probably give him one more crack here to try to give him all we got. But it looks like he's a soft commit to BYU. We look at what else is out there. Some of these guys in the 60s. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to pursue them. If they sign on as our last signings, then fine. But I'm not going to pursue them hard with recruiting time. They can make their college decisions on their own without any pushing from me. So here we go with a few of these guys. And we're going to advance the week now. And we do have a bye week coming up, which, you know, I think I mapped this out before about Robert Vincent when he first got hurt. Here you go. Collins and Haynes both sign on as committed UMass recruits there. So welcome them in. And like I said, we do have the bye week. But when Robert Vincent first went down, I think I mapped this out. And this bye week comes at a great time because I think he'll actually be available for the Miami game here, which will be big. So you see Larry Thompson, we'd love to have him. James Barnes, 80 overall halfback, 4-star. Oh, he committed right on the spot. Look at that. We got James Barnes. Oh, boy, are we really going to have a crowded backfield next year? My goodness, these guys are going to have to really come out and impress and perform. And this is a good problem to have. A lot of good halfbacks in the fold for next year. We got Drew Barber, an athlete we're going after. Okay, that's going to pretty much do it for the recruiting. Like I said, when we advance this week, we're going to find out. We obviously have a commit because it committed right on the spot. That's Barnes. And we have a big game here to round out the regular season. As if we needed a test here to try to run the undefeated season, at least through regular season, we got to go play the U. We got to go play at Miami, number 13 at 6-4. 6-4, a little surprising for number 13, but we got to go get it done in hostile territory if we want to go 12-0. Can we do it? Come on back next.